Internal cancers can cause skin symptoms mainly through a mechanism called paraneoplastic syndrome. This disorder occurs through two different ways. First, cancer cells begin to produce and release hormones or certain proteins that negatively affect skin tissue. Besides, white blood cells and antibodies responsible for fighting against cancerous cells may mistakenly attack normal skin cells. Both of these mechanisms eventually lead to destruction of healthy skin cells. Symptoms of paraneoplastic syndromes often precede the diagnosis of cancer. In this video, we want to have a look at top 7 skin symptoms of internal cancers. The first one is lesser Trelat sign. As you see, this sign is characterized by abrupt appearance of multiple pigmented skin lesions. These lesions are so-called seborrheic keratosis. A wide range of malignancies, especially gastrointestinal cancers like stomach, liver, colorectal, or pancreatic cancers, are the most common cause. In about half of patients, lesions resolve after treating the underlying malignancy. Sweet syndrome is the second skin sign. With Sweet syndrome, patients develop painful red or bluish rash on the arms, face, neck, and trunk. In addition to skin lesions, fever and high neutrophil count are present. This syndrome is mostly associated with blood cancers such as leukemia or lymphoma. Although benign conditions like obesity and diabetes are the most common causes of acanthosis nigricans, cancers, especially stomach cancer, can be the cause as well. It typically represents as dark, velvety, thick plaques in armpits, groins, and back of the neck. Dermatomyositis is another skin condition linked to various internal cancers. It's an inflammatory disease present with muscle weakness and specific skin lesions. Scaly purple papules over the back of fingers, elbows, or knees known as Gautran papules. Bluish purple patches over the periorbital skin known as heliotrope rash. And fixed redness extending across the nuchal area, shoulders, and upper back that is so-called shawl sign, are among the top 3 skin manifestations of dermatomyositis. Dermatomyositis is associated with a 6-fold higher risk of malignancy compared with general population. Solid cancers including ovarian, cervical, breast, gastric, colon, pancreatic, and lung cancers are the most common ones. Exceptionally, dermatomyositis doesn't increase the cancer risk in pediatrics. The fifth symptom is ichthyosis. With ichthyosis, affected skin appears dry, scaly, and rough. A wide range of diseases including kidney failure, cancers, sarcoidosis, and HIV infection can induce ichthyosis. Among cancers, Hodgkin lymphoma is the most common associated malignancy. Sometimes malignancies present with intense and diffuse erythema of the skin that involves over 90% of the skin surface area. This condition is known as erythroderma. Sometimes enlarged lymph nodes and itching are present. Although erythroderma is often due to severe eczema, psoriasis, and drug reactions, cancers, especially lymphoid malignancies, may induce this condition as well. The last one, but not the least one, is paraneoplastic pemphigus. It's a disease that develops blisters and sores on the skin, mouth, nose, throat, and eyes. Severe painful stomatitis is the earliest and most common. As you see, there are sores and erosions across the oral mucosa and tongue. Nearly all patients with paraneoplastic pemphigus have a confirmed or hidden cancer. It is often caused by blood cancers, particularly non-Hodgkin lymphoma. If you know any other skin disorders that can herald the onset of malignancies, write them in the comments down below.